We are on our Thursday primetime game, first game of the recap. This week I'm doing them fast because I'm running a bit low on time. Hopefully these speed up and I can get a little more prepared in advance. This week I'm kind of running under the wire. So yeah, we're going to kind of kick things off. Rams-Bills. If these games are close, I will go down to normal in the fourth. So I'm going to sim quarter by quarter. Just because it doesn't take that much longer. And post games, I'd like to see kind of more of it. So we're going to kick things off here. Maybe. X. Thank you. First quarter, Buffalo jumps out to a touchdown lead, but Rams answer the field goal. Okay. Buffalo Bills out to a 14-3 lead. The Rams can't really answer, so that's how we're going to the half. Get one more quarter here. And Rams cannot capitalize. Buffalo out to a 21-3 lead. Probably running away with this game, so we'll go ahead and we'll go ahead and end the game yet. It's not doing the down. There it is. End of game. Buffalo 24-3. They get a goal line stop. Rams do put a touchdown up on the board, but that's how we're going to end it. Buffalo with a 24-10 win. Rex Ryan back in Buffalo getting his first win against the Rams.
Yeah, I think it makes it special, right? Makes it so that everyone is just watching, all eyes on.
But yeah, we'll take a look at the stats here. You got to know what happened. Josh Allen with two touchdowns, no pick, 120 pass rating, 239 yards. Stafford with 195 yards through the air and a pick. Opening up on Thursday night so again. Yeah, not necessarily great offense for the Rams, so I'd go past rating for him here.
So for the Bills, Josh Allen's good. Zach Moss, 70 yards, calm it down, having himself a nice game. They'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week, where they take on the Tennessee Titans.
With a shift, Robert Woods has a huge game, 10 for 88. Cup, having a nice game, 6 for 51. Stephon Diggs, 6 for 80, with 2 touchdowns, so... Yeah, that's huge. AJ Green, Juju, and Gabe Davis will kind of put down Juju's 84 yards. So a lot of big plays for them. We got a long reception. Juju had 20, Diggs had 30, or 27, Diggs had 30. Our blocking. Few sacks allowed, some pressure overall. Tremaine Evans leading in tackles. Tackle for losses, Leonard Floyd leading the way on that. Aaron Donald getting the one. Aaron Donald with 2.5 sacks. Take this game off the set. Rams defensive front, Edmonds and Lorne with the sacks. I don't know if that's right, but then Floyd and Johnson. So, and then for the picks, Faxon got it, I guess. Deflections, Milano, Edmonds, and John Johnson. There's no forced fumbles, so there's no recoveries, no blocks, no safeties, and no defensive touchdowns. Both kickers were good. Actually, wait. Bass, he missed a... What did he miss? He missed a 50-yarder. You can miss 50-yarders. Hacker. And then scoring summary here. So you got a 7-yard touchdown pass from Diggs that kicked us off. Field goal, another Diggs touchdown. Debris to run. And then Cooper Kupp returns a punt for a touchdown. Is their only touchdown of the day, so 88 yards. You love to see it. So just take a look at the team stats real quick. You know, Bills really run the ball pretty well. Didn't turn the ball over, good up there down. This is how you win games. So yeah, that's gonna wrap up the first game. We're gonna do this in sections again, like we used to, because I'm not prepared in advance. So, peace. Number 2, Falcons playing host to division rival New Orleans Saints. The Saints are obviously hoping for Jamar Chase and continue to get things rolling for him. Matt Ryan coming off of a nearly MVP campaign for the Falcons, looking to get this team over the hump, get them in the playoffs. They lost a lot of weapons, but they gained a lot on defense. Hopefully, Matt Ryan continues to elevate this offense, and the defense can now be to par and get them into the playoffs. Thanks for recording. What's up, dude? And let's go scoring yet. Saints jump out first with the touchdown. Saints jump out to a 10-0 lead, but Atlanta answers quickly with three straight scores in the half. 17-10 game, 20-10, 27-10. They really ran away with this one. And Atlanta is going to take the win, 27-10.
This was a division game, but Atlanta is going to come through with a win over the Saints.
Hartshell.
So for Atlanta, that'll be a happy locker room as they start the season 1-0. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Los Angeles Rams.
Matt Ryan didn't have a pretty good game. He had 68 yards, but a touchdown and a pick.
And they'll look to get back on the beam next week as they host the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Not a pretty bad game or a pretty good game for either quarterback, but the ACFL team. The running back really got going, so it must have been Elijah Mitchell, some two touchdowns, of course. So that's a big part of their offense. But I'm going to get some of my defensive scores here, really. Well, probably not, because 27 is three touchdowns. We're going to hit some turnovers now. Isaiah McKenzie had a huge game. Jason, with 68 yards, 61 yards. Tower at 50, Ray at 547, all right around that same range. Cam Ward not getting too much involved. Ah, it's a sacks. Daddy and Nixon will also only two times for losses. Oh, that's two sack numbers here. Robert playing with three. Joe Hughes 2.5. Rankins with 2. Ingram and Jordan with 1. Ogle with 1. Bucky. I took 3 players out for the Falcons. I've seen 2 of them, I guess. Love it. This is annoying. He's going to their pick. Mitchell 3-yard run, McKenzie pass, and Mitchell 4-yard run. Got a field goal sprinkled in there for each team. Alright, now into the game. Stand up, Panthers playing host to the Browns. This is the Baker Mayfield revenge game. Let's get it going. Hopefully this one is a good game. Maybe a little high scoring affair even. As we got Ritter, who replaces him, taking over. And Cleveland strikes first, and second, Carolina gets 3 on the board, though, before the end of the quarter. Cleveland, a nice long drive that stalls out. Carolina answers quick on the touchdown and takes 2 touchdowns, but Cleveland answers quick again, up to 17-7 there by the end of the half. Head to the third quarter now. Carolina's the ball, and they strike right away. Both getting the field goal on their first drive, and let's go ahead and let's slow this thing down a little bit. Let's view this thing on normal, and let's get this game. CMC with a 16-yard catch and a DJ Moore touchdown for the 27-20 game. Nick Chubb running it down the Panthers' throat right now. Javon Bernard steps in to get one, and Ritter throws the pass away. 3rd and 5. Offside. And Horn's hurt. It wasn't offside then, I guess. I don't know, it could have been. And Nick Chubb, a 9-yard run. He's just very good at football. They're marching right down the field on him. Ritter to Lazard. Ritter to Woods for 9, and Winovich hurt on the play. And Jadovich gets the touchdown catch, even in the game, back up at 27, shootout here in Carolina. Auden Tate with the catch. Speeding on Tate right now, 4 yards on first down, and then Carpenter gets a hold. Second 20 coming up. And dropped pass, 3rd and 20, and incomplete. We're gonna see a punt here. So Cleveland a chance to take the lead with 4:07 to go. And a DPJ, 17-yard catch. Third and one. Lazard moves the chains, and Chubb's gonna kick him into field goal range here. And a chase on roughing the passer's gotta be. That's killer right there. Third and four. And a touchdown run from Nick Chubb takes a 34-27 lead. Yards to DJ Moore. Dropped it. Third and 10. Two more downs. And sacked by Dalvin Tomlinson. 4th and 16. And they get it. Auden Tate, 26 yards. Let's go ahead. Really? It's my show. I can watch it. Oh, I missed the play. Oh, no. I missed the touchdown. I'm sorry. We'll see how they scored it in a bit. Damn. I was the second slow on my show call. Ah.
This will be fielded inside the 5. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage.
All right, 40 seconds slow. Decent, man. DPJ with 162 receiving yards on the game. Absolute monster.
Well, partner, here it is. They've got the chance to win the game. You'd have to think they need to get it near the opposite 40 to have a chance to kick a game-winning
and
field.
And oh, my. Dangerous throw there from Ritter. Just like got himself picked off.
But I think in micro, the head coach has already asked the special teams coach, what is he feeling? What does he think? What does he want the football? What's the yard line we have to get? And he's already relayed that to his quarterback and his offense. They know what the goal
nice
is.
Nice out route there.
Now
is that Peoples Jones?
Can they get there?
And he's going to pick up a first
oh,
down.
Oh, get down enough. You guys call a timeout there. I don't know if there's time for all these timeouts. Oh, no. Rookie. They can do 170 yards. Quick out, got it caught, got it out of bounds. Lazard. Okay, 279 yards and 2 touchdowns for Ritter. That's the monster game. Get close to a dual chance. Across the middle. Lazard's got it, timeout. Okay, 47. We're going to need another, for a reasonable field goal attempt, they're going to need another 10 yards.
With 7 seconds left. So
now
they
oh, they're going to lose
the shoulders of Josh Lambeau. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. This from Tom Dempsey range here. And this
short
one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good. And a costly one there as this game remains tied here in the fourth.
Boy, that's a big-time letdown
there.
You
3 seconds left. Dude, Baker can go ahead and punch this thing in the end zone.
No good. Now you've got to regroup as a team, get the energy back up, and get ready for overtime. And make sure
going for it all, you have it.
He may be needed to try and win it again later.
And got it, got
it.
394, 4 touchdowns, and a pick for Baker. Jeez. Talk about a quarterback duel here. Both of these running the ball really well, too, really.
If the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving
let's
team
go ahead
throws
and,
a pick
normal sim. This is taking me a bit longer, so let's just watch it on normal. Cleveland or Carolina will get the ball first. Cleveland kicked off. Auden Tate with another big catch. Third and one. And McCaffrey picks it up. Baker getting in on the running action here. Third and four though. Right on the outside of field goal range. And Auden Tate again moves the sticks. He's got almost 2 yards receiving at this point. McCaffrey brings him down to a third and short. And Auden Tate brings him down to first and goal. Down to the three. And we need to play it himself. Carolina in a shootout. Coming out 40-34 victory for the Panthers here. Absolutely awesome game. Super high scoring. Let's go ahead and start with the score summary. Because he has a 3-point touchdown from Ritter, a couple field goals. Then McCaffrey getting 2 touchdown passes from Baker. Peoples Jones on 70 yards now from Ritter. DJ Morgan touchdown to the lead shot. And then Auden Tate 25 yards and then he missed. Jump in the watch. Meanwhile, for the Browns, again,
they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll be back home next week for a date with the New York Jets.
As you look here, Baker and Ritter both absolutely balling the fuck out. Ritter has a 78% pitch percentage. He does throw a pass for a 146 passing rate. I think that's close to about anything, 146.3 or something. But nearly 400 yards. I mean, we did everything you could expect for this game. But Baker, a little bit inefficient, down and down, but 451 yards and 5 touchdowns. Hell of a game. He's had a huge pass that did it. Trying to help carry it. But Chubb with 83 yards, Caffrey with 61 on 20 carries. Baker getting involved in the running game a little bit there. Auden Tate, 197 yards. I mean, just incredible game. Look at all these. All of them. Ooh, Pickens got hurt. Just wondering. So that could be huge for him. Seems there was some work on him the other day. But obviously, yeah, Donovan Jones stepped up in his absence. Lazard did as well, but Pickens injury, so. Keep going. Two sacks there. Jamin Davis had a nice game. Derek Brown, an animal. 4 times for losses. Charles Harris. Nassif had a nice game. Garrett was a little bit quiet, actually. 2 times for losses. Bad. Winovich, Harris. Let's see. Farley with a pick. Jason Moore with 2 passes deflected. But yeah, that's going to do it for our game here. And yeah, hopefully that injury isn't too serious for Pickens. All right, another game on tap here. Niners heading to Chicago to take on the Bears. Realistically, this is a Niners game that can win. But the Bears are a scrappy team. They were in a lot of close games last year. They lost a lot of them. So could put themselves in this position to win this game at the end. Then at that point, you can win this ball game. As we do, going through the quarters. Chicago jumps out 3-0 on them. And then San Francisco answers. They touchdown, so 7-3 at the end of the first. Chicago keeping the pressure on them, get the touchdown. San Francisco answers with a touchdown of their own, but Chicago comes right back. Back and forth game 21-7. San Francisco at the half. Chicago, just guys saying it. Got a big stop and a big score. Okay, going on to normal. See what happens here. 21-24 at the quarter. The Niners are knocking on the door, first and 10 on the 14-yard line. And Deebo Samuel gets him to the 1 yard line. And Trey Sermon knocks him in, take the lead back. 28-24. Kirk Cousins and company can march right back down the field on him to start the fourth quarter. Short runs by Montgomery. And then Kirk Cousins gets sacked by the new addition, Zuzinga, Kyle Donaldson. A punt. Niners can put the game away if they get this thing moving. Deebo gets some carries and he gets hurt. That's tough. Drive stalls out after the injury. But great punt gets down to the 3. Wow. What a punt. Kirk Cousins keeps the chase moving. Montgomery with another successful run on first. 3rd and 6 coming up. And there it is, another punt. Offense is really slowed down here in the fourth when we started watching. Deebo is back. Gets a long return. 3rd and 1. Nice. Trey Sermon gashing him right now. Kittle with the catch. Deebo with another run, get him the first. Laquon Treadwell, 9 yard catch. Deebo again, all over this game. Sermon gets a loss, but 2nd and 13. 3rd and 11 coming up. And then we did whatever. And Golson gets hurt on the field goal. So a touchdown game. Kirk Cousins is gonna need some magic here, a 2 minute drill. 3 timeouts, so plenty of time. And that's a great start, Agnew with a 29 yard catch. There we go. False start. Damian Pierce gets some action. And knocked away. But Allen Robinson on fourth down gets him the first. Allen Robinson again gets him down to first and goal. And he gets sacked, though. Sacked again. 3rd and goal on the 22-yard line. All right, 4th and goal on the 10 for the game. And that's the game. DeMario Davis. 2 big deflections on the game. So that'll end it. The Niners will take this one. 31-24. A great game to say the least. Both quarterbacks playing really well. Fields just shy of 200 yards. And it's good to be back in the booth with you as well. Ayuk gets the first touchdown. Fields. Montgomery gets a run. Sermon. This is how they start answering more. You make your most progress and between Booty, week 1 and week 2. 25 yarder, Montgomery, and Sermon and Siebert end up giving them the lead and then extending it to the touchdown. So,
it was a hard fought game. And they'll exit Kirk Cousins is pretty solid.
That can be a little bit better, but you know, you can't really argue with the pretty efficient 100 rating.
Meanwhile, for Chicago, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat.
Rushing, they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to Lambeau to take on the Packers. With Deebo with 100 yards through the air, Ayuk with 93 and 2 touchdowns. Kyle Robinson had a nice game as well as Komet. And Traylon Burks getting 3 catches, 63 yards. Pretty nice too. Quite a bit of sacks allowed too. See some numbers on defense here. As Golston has 3 tackle for losses and a sack. He's hurt. Highsmith, 2 sacks and 2 tackle for losses. For Steele, let me see it. Brian Burns getting 2 sacks. The new addition for them, balling out. We didn't hear from Nick Bosa very much. That's going to be a good game. One tackle, but Nick Bosa. But you know, you'll have that. It's alright. Maybe it was the 2 on the last drive. Fred Warner forced home, but they couldn't recover. So yeah, that'll do it. Another nice game in the books. 31-24. The Niners jump out to a win on their first game of the season. So far, the only NFC West team to have a win. We had the Cardinals and Chiefs coming up as the last one, but they can have sole pick their first place. That is magical for sure, but it still is true. So, the next game we'll see there. Here we are at Ford Field here in Detroit. The Lions are playing host to the Philadelphia Eagles here in Week 1. Should be a good match. We got Andy Reid back in Philadelphia coaching Jalen Hurts. And we have Dan Campbell still coaching the Lions. Nothing weird there. But should be an entertaining game. I was going to watch the first play. Gets me. Oh my. All right, third time's charm. Okay, we're back. It's not like doing the down very good. Lions get the field goal first. Philly answered the field goal of their own. Kicking contest. And Detroit scores the first touchdown. But Philly answers very quick for the half. I forgot to do by quarter when I actually got there. Nice and close game. You know what that means. Back to normal. And it's going to be a punt. There you go. Philadelphia a chance to take the lead in the fourth. Nice first down. They're knocked away by Okuda, so they're going to punt it right back to him. Yeah, a touchback right there. That's tough. That first, Jahan Dotson gets the catch. Third and four. And Dotson again coming through for the first down. Approaching midfield there. Can't quite get there. Third and five. And that's going to be another punt here at midfield. Down to the 21 is the return. A great return on such a short punt. And Hurts gets sacked by Abukam. Goddard gets it back all those yards, gets a bit more, third and five, and it's not going to do it. Another punt here coming up. Lions, it's good feels just to go after the short punt and a return. Looking at, 60 yards to go, 240. Nico Collins with a 17-yard catch, going to get him down there, and a 5-yard penalty, a big play somewhere in there that we missed. Here they are on the goal line, first and goal on the 5. And a touchdown run by Tyler Algier, 17-10. Lions are up. Philly's gonna have a chance to answer here. The minute 36 and 3 timeouts. And Quez Watkins gonna get him started with a 25-yard catch. Goddard, 18 yards, marching right down the field. JOK though holds the progress with pass deflection. Goddard picks him back up. Puka gets the first. Alright, plenty of time. And an 11-yard run to get him first and goal on the 9. And a touchdown pass to Quez Watkins. So, maybe he scored even a little too quick because there's still 44 seconds left for the Lions. See if Jared Goff can make some magic happen. 25 yards to Nico Collins. That's a great start. 27 to Nico Collins. They're in field goal range now. This fucking game, man. This should have been game over. Really should have been. That's so tough. Unless they missed a field goal at the end. We'll look, but that's shitty clock management. Just keeps the field goal fucking 10 seconds left. Who cares? The Eagles are marching. Who's that? Alright, they forced him to punt though. Oh, they kicked a field goal. Oh, that's not good. They tried it, but the Lions are going to have a chance to make up for their mistake. But Josh Sweat forced him to the third and long. And that's Micah Parsons getting the sack, so they're going to punt it back. 15-yard line. 4th-19 to go. Quez Watkins, big play. Goddard. That's the game.
Always a little extra excitement for Week 1, and one of our early window games here in Week 1 on a Sunday comes to a close. Good to be back in the booth with you, my friend.
There you go. The Eagles score touchdown. That's brutal because really the Lions had that. I would love to see what happened at the end of that game.
And how many coaches tell us every single year, you make your most progress between week one and week two. We'll see how both of these teams progress the rest of the season.
So for Philadelphia, hey, you get a win, you get it on the road.
What
you
happened?
Can't ask for much more than that to start the year. And they will head home next week to take on the Minnesota Vikings. Meanwhile, for Detroit,
great win for the Eagles, though, I guess.
That sucks, but Hurts is amazing.
355 yards, two touchdowns. Swift is pretty solid for him. Puka Williams is the only running back they had, really. I'm shocked with Culver getting so much run in the fourth that they didn't end up putting CMC back in. Nico Collins, 129 yards, got it with 96. Hawkins, 68. Elijah Moore had a nice game. Run around Clayton Brown, had 88 yards and a touchdown. Plays Watson with the two touchdowns, of course. Off the sack score. Devin White, 14 tackles. James Hill, 9. Hutchinson with 2, tied for losses and a half sack. Josh Sweat and Parsons combining for 5 sacks. He's good. John Howard forces in for a fumble. But yeah, that's a tough one because really the Lions should have won this one. But the Eagles capitalize overtime and get the win. Alright, back to another game. Gonna try to pick up the pace a little bit, Colts versus Texans, just because I realized that I probably recorded like 30 or so minutes and not half the games. And I think it's limited me to that, so I may be trimming some games, which I don't wanna do. So we'll see how this goes. Seven to seven. I start 14. Colts 14-7, and they will take 17-7 into half. And that's they really ran out with that one, kind of that second and third quarter. But Houston clawing away at them, down to a score game. They just couldn't get that last stop in that rushing attack. 24-21 victory for the Colts, holding on to win. So we got Garrett Wilson with 2 touchdowns in respect. 22 yards each start, missing that field goal. That's going to hurt.
But you open within the division,
it's fine.
You knew the motivation was going to be there on both sidelines. One just executed better and earned the win.
Houston win?
So for Indianapolis, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory here by a field goal. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Jacksonville to take on the Jaguars. Meanwhile, for the Texans, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll look to get back on track next week as they travel to Denver to take on the Broncos.
I don't know. Well, so much for speed. I have no idea what the fuck happened. Okay, we'll zoom through the stats here. Rashad only has 1 touchdown, but on the scoring summary, he has 3. Jonathan Taylor's 100 yards, and he's behind, scored a touchdown. Sure, Rashad's got a rushing touchdown. T.Y., huge game, 2 touchdowns. Garrett Wilson having 1 touchdown, not 2, but maybe 2, I don't know. Take 2. Action. Byron Jones comes in here ruining this game. Honestly. Alright, come on. Go next. Drew Lock starts with a touchdown this time. Miami answers the field goal. He punts. Very fun. Field goal for Miami again. And they score a touchdown at the end of the half, though. Cut to the score game. New England a touchdown. And New England takes a huge win here on the road.
33 for a brand new season, but this was a division game here in week one. And to come through with a 1-0 start against a division opponent gives you a little something extra heading forward for the rest of the season.
Yeah, let's pile it all into one game, right? Opening the season, and you open within the division. You knew the motivation was going to be
there. Drew Lock, 126 pass rating, 3 touchdowns, no picks. Tua, not as good. 91 passer rating.
Hey, you get a win, you get it on the road. You can't ask for much more than that to start the year.
Damien Harris had a nice game. Najee missed just a big run. Meanwhile, for Miami,
they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Baltimore Ravens.
Will fucking Fuller. Holy shit. You lost a game when Will Fuller puts up 161 yards? Jarvis Landry did not hurt this time. He's hurt last time. I don't know how bad that was. Yikes. Will fucking Fuller. Jermaine Johnson had a nice first start there. Drew Donovan Reddick keeps getting the sack. Devin McCourty getting the only interception of the game. Bolton and Keyboard both getting the pass collection. No force fumbles. Oh, I guess we need to score somewhere. Excuse me, sorry. Jonnu with touchdown first. And then Amari Cooper getting one. Will Fuller, 48 yarder. Landry. And a bunch of Robbie Gold field goals, putting them out of reach. And then Parker with the touchdown to kind of cut the deficit by just a little bit. Anyway, 33-20. That's the game. Patriots 1-0. Hey, everybody. Back in another game. Jets Ravens. Jets play host to this one. We're just going to get right into it.
It's week one of the NFL, and we'll see who.
The Baltimore just a quick turnover. It had to. Just up to a 10-0 lead, 17-0 lead. That's the Jets start fighting back here. The Ravens, wow, put that away right there. Just a tough stretch for the Jets. Made it a game, no, they made it closer near the end, but that was a brutal stretch then for the corner. Ravens, go ahead and take that one. Good for Mel. Take the first bell. So let's look at that. So Andrew's 6-yard pass. Tucker's 6-yarder. Andrew's 12-yard pass. Brees Hall at 57-yard touchdown. Justin Tucker, field goal. Lamar Jackson, two straight runs. A Gallup touchdown.
So for Baltimore, who was on the Ravens that day?
Ingram,
you get
touchdown,
it on the road.
Pass.
You can't ask for much more than that to start the year.
Last
and they'll return home next week to take on the Miami Dolphins.
Yeah,
meanwhile, for the Jets, they go down to defeat here
wow,
in the opener.
Wow, three
and they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Cleveland to take on the Browns.
250 yards, but two takes is just tough. And that's probably led to a lot of their quick scores, their quick turnarounds. Lamar wasn't very good either. I mean, 14-21, 140 yards is fine. That sounds good. Didn't turn the ball over, so that was a big thing. Rossi is coming to three. Yeah. Definitely. But yeah, things are rushing stats. Lamar had a good game. Brees Hall, 72 yards, but almost all of them were one carry. I really bench Dobbin so far. He didn't do anything. That's good. Mark Ingram, 8 for 89, 2 touchdowns. Gallups, 5 for 92 with a touchdown. Drake London getting 4 for 87. Odell having a slow game. And Sean Jackson, not appealing. Akari, Stanley, Peters, 2 sacks flat each. That was a big game. Somebody, Davenport for 3 sacks. That's his game. Good debut here for the Jets, Mark Davenport. Quentin Williams, 2 title philosophers. Trayvon Walker with a debut, being a 2 title philosopher on staff. We can see that too. But yeah, it's a lot of fun spread out production. Corey Davis with 1 tackle. You love to see it. What an animal, this guy. Malik Harrison, Elijah Molden, and Marcus Peters all picking off James Winston. Even SML getting in on the fun, but in the past, but no forced fumbles. And yeah, that'll be the game. Ravens, you know, just too many turnovers for Winston for the Jets to overcome. And Ravens take this one 38-21. All right, everybody. We're getting to the home stretch here. 4 games remaining. Jaguars and Commanders facing off here, heading to Washington. Should be an interesting game. Commanders had a rough season last year. Jaguars were very good, made the playoffs. Both teams looking to be those playoff teams again this year. Washington's a great coach for it, but with another year development here, you know, now second to four guys. So, I mean, the Jaguars are looking to kind of take a step up. They won the division last year, but they have to hold some teams to their feet for a lot of the year. They want to win it in a year where the Titans and Colts will play more like themselves, just to show everybody, like myself, the doubters, that they were legit. So Washington jumped out to a 10-0 lead on in the start, but Jess was a very good second half team as a good defense in the second half. So that was their calling card as he's kind of come back. So see if they can pull off another one. If they do cut it to one possession, they tie. Oh, they don't tie the game. They do take the lead. And Washington cannot win it. The Jets were both off the comeback. They couldn't quite tie it. They missed the extra point, but they beat the ball back.
Sunday comes to a close. Good to be back in the booth with you, my friend.
And it's good to be back in the booth with you as well. And we know that not everyone's going to start the season 1-0, right? Half the league is going to have a loss on their record. But everyone's going to have to build off of that opener. And how many coaches tell us every single year, you make your most progress between week 1 and week 2. We'll see how both of these teams progress the rest of this season.
So for Jacksonville, it was a hard-fought game, and they'll exit 1-0 as they win by a touchdown. And they'll return home next week to take on the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for the Commanders, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll look to get back on track next week as they travel up to Detroit to take on the Lions.
Kenny Galladay did touchdown. Those player stats. Yeah, Trey Lance Nutek doesn't get a touchdown. Wade Lawrence is a little bit more up. They're a bit mixed. 313 yards, 2 touchdowns for the pick. Had that 14 yarder, big one. Gibson, he ran the ball pretty consistently. I see the pace of him, really. Both teams just doing alright. Logan Thomas having a nice game. CJ Chark also in a nice game, so that's 62. Byron Pringle, that big pet held 5 for 94. Pretty round game. Terry Ollie is the winning touchdown catch. Terry was a little bit quiet. Not a lot of stuff. He's up. So, Kyle Filosofi, Buddy Johnson gets in, I guess, and gets two. Sure. Not even on like the depth chart, but he's got two. Josh Allen, Sweat, and then Clowney in Ruzio. Or whatever. Come on, first class. Gilmore and King get the picks. Boye, Henderson, and Holt with the interceptions. There was 2 forced fumbles, both covered by Jacksonville. Obviously, kind of had to turn the tide there. Hughes and Phillips, each forced and cover one. I feel like they're rushing to see if he fumbled it. McKenzie fumbled one, doesn't do it. So, that's the game. Here's the next one. Alright, we're back with another big game here. Two playoff teams, these likely two Chiefs having, and they both have 2 boys, aspirations for the top 6-7 rated teams in the league. Both are looking for that. The Cardinals, however, are going to have a a bit of a disadvantage to kick us off, you know, being without DeAndre Hopkins for six games. And they don't really have an easy part of their schedule, so they're going to need to win some games without him. And I guess that's what's going to come into if they could pull it out and kind of keep things rolling. So we're going to kick this game off. Chiefs at Cardinals. One of the last few games here in the week. But here we go. Cardinals kick off with a touchdown. Chiefs answer. Cardinals get a field goal. Can't get the ball back, but Chiefs get a stop. Two field goals for the Cardinals, but the Chiefs wipe that off the board with a touchdown. 14-13, 21-13. And the Chiefs jump out to a two-score lead. Cardinals cut it to one. And the Chiefs put the game away. 31-19 is our final score. Chiefs, a little too much firepower here for the Cardinals. Ryan Day getting lost in the first game. And Bill Cowher here for the Chiefs getting his first win as the Chiefs head coach. Lots of students pitch around the other way here. But wow, looks like a hell of a game from Bowen. Just go ahead and check out the scoring summary here. Ronald Jones kicked it off with a touchdown. A Russell Gage touchdown. You know, a lot of that around here. Maher field goal gives him the lead, but then the Kelce touchdown.
So the Chiefs lead, they do not give up. And they will head home next week to take on the LA Chargers. Meanwhile, for Arizona, they go down to defeat me, here in
kick.
The opener.
Harley, they will try to get back in the swing of things next week. The game away. On the road. Touchdown. Touchdown in the fourth kind of cuts the gap. Mahomes, though, an awesome game. 356 yards, 4 touchdowns and a pick. Kyler, though, a brutal game. Only 2 picks. No touchdowns, 2 picks, 269 yards. Not a great game from him. But, as you see, Kyler's good on the ground. Saquon, however, 9-17, that's not good. Pretty good to do. So they couldn't really run the ball, and they turned the ball over too much. Kelce was huge. Kirk had an awesome game, 6-1-12. Russell Gage was big. Hardy had the touchdown catch. Tyreek Hill, pretty all right. Colby had a decent game, I guess. Hubbard went down with an injury. Niang with a touchdown catch. He looked to see the line with the 6-point touchdown. Blocking. Not too many sacks. The Chiefs did not get much pressure last year, and the Cardinals are better with pass rushers, so we should see how that goes for each of these teams. And they just split up the sack team. Jimmy Jones and Chris Jones, though. Jones is in the Hicks. Next. Buda Baker and Nicholas Morrow getting the picks. Oh, and Gregory Jr. Chris Harris does force one, but that's good. That's our game, folks. Chiefs coming up 1-0, Cardinals losing, which means that the Niners defeating the Bears as the only team to win in the NFC West. They have sole possession of first place heading into week 2, so good for them. And someone gives you.
Hey y'all, another sim, Raiders and Chargers. Chargers play host here, Raiders heading on the road.
Raiders won't win the team this year.
I wasn't very high on them in the preview, but I've been wrong plenty of times.
So you start the Raiders getting a quick score, 2 quick scores, but Chargers do answer quickly again. Kind of like the first quarter though. Chargers even the odds in the middle of the second. Raiders take the lead. Chargers again answer even at half 21. Chargers take the lead. Raiders take it right back. And the Chargers tie it up. And the Chargers win it. On a minute drive, the Raiders got the home kick and field goal as the Chargers right back down. Back to touchdown. 1-0
start against a division opponent gives you a little something extra heading forward for the rest of the season.
Yeah, let's pile it all into one game, right? Opening the season and you open
wow,
the division.
What a game. Both corrected and get balled out. Let's go ahead and check the
executed better and earned the win.
Marquise Brown gets his first touchdown as a Raider.
They begin the new year 1-0 as they come out victorious here.
And then Keenan Allen, touchdown, he's supposed to play. I'm just moving the Byron Robinson touchdown to raise. At least that was Kelly, who was supposed to be there instead of Robinson. Max Williams, touchdown run. Shakir, gets the touchdown catch. Eckler and Jacobs a lot. Hey, there's Shakir again, two of them. Good game. I guess he was the leading team. He had the guy score with 70 fucking yard touchdown, or 40 yard touchdown. But, you know, it's a good. Herbert, three interceptions. So to overcome three interceptions, that's a hell of a game. Carr was much cleaner, but he didn't even throw it with Williams. So, the rushing attack, Jacobs is good. Eckler is good. The team's kind of similar. You know, Jacobs had those days, but that's a really good addition. Jacobs does fumble it. That's a different stuff. Hunter Henry, a huge two-hud, is injured. He's got really keen out in an equally huge game against Hector. Renfro's nice. Shakir, a good move. Marquise Brown, Nicholas. Oh, there he is. I benched him too. Darren Waller playing. So the Raiders got two guys who shouldn't have played at the play. Oh, didn't even matter. Nothing. DJ Mosley, Derwin James, Joey Bosa, Cleland Fitz. Alright, just Moss was in the game, Max Crosby for sack, and then Bosa helped clean up the Bosa sack. Terrell Kitchen. He's covered trading for like into 30. He had to turn it right to him. Oh man. Oh, that's brutal. CJ Mosley forces the first ball. Alright, well, yeah, see you on the next one. One game left. Last game of the week. Sunday primetime, Bucks Cowboys. Should be a good game. Or not. But.
It's week one of the 2022 season, and it's brought to you by
Dallas drives, he's still going first, it's a stop even, but Bucks come out with a touchdown in the second drive. Dallas gets another touchdown answer, back and forth, and Dallas and Tampa scoring the last little bit. They have a 23-17 and a half. Dallas cuts it to one score, takes the lead in the fourth. Tampa cuts to one, up to eight, tied, and Dallas takes the lead. They tied it up. Tampa with a field goal, and they tied. They win.
Week one primetime games, they always seem to have
one.
A little bit more electricity.
Dallas, let's go! Overtime game, Dallas wins in a touchdown. The Bucks got a field goal, but Dallas came rushing right back down and scored a touchdown. Let's fucking go, baby! Look at this game! Look at this game! 600 yards total offense. Yeah, that's awesome. Hey, both players were balling the fuck out. 93.6%. That's true, that's insane. Woo! Yeah, they were.
So for the Cowboys, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory
start
by a
field goal.
And they'll have another update next week as the Cincinnati Bengals come to town. Meanwhile, for Tampa Bay, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in New Orleans against the Saints.
Johnson field goal, Prescott run, Goddard with a long touchdown, and then just trade field goals out, and then Johnson, and then Elliott, runs on the screen, 36-yard touchdown, and takes the house. Let's go. Both these quarterbacks, Brady being the only pick of the game, so his pass rate is lower, but I mean, 17 penetration, 4 touchdowns, 478 yards, awesome. Prescott with 410, 68 penetration, 4 touchdowns himself, killing it. Zeke is good on the ground. Oh, actually, no, he's 2.2. Yeah, so the running games were high volume, but inefficient. Let's see, Godwin with 8, 189, Lamb with 123, Eddie 128, Jacoby Myers with 100 even, O'Shaughnessy stepping up, Tatanian getting 72, Earth 75. Whew,
Cobb only had 4 catches, but he threw 2 touchdowns. You love to see that. Zeke with only 2 catches, and 1 touchdown. He won the goddamn game. Woo! Let's fucking go. Tyron Smith decided to play that. That's fun. I put him on Graves for half the team. Graves is going to need a tackle. But yeah, he let us out. So. Joe Hayden with 14 fucking tackles. He's in the slot, though. That's how he gets it. Vita Vea, DeMarcus Lawrence, Randy Gregory. Oh, Smalls had a colossal. Awesome game for them. Shaq Barrett, 2 sacks. Irvin, Gregory, Vea, and Campbell. Seth Heath, Dean getting in on a half sack. Down 2. Anthony Barr was the only pick of the game of Brady. Takes a 30 and nice, too. Questions. By game for Satana, which is a good thing for a corner. Hey, he tackled, I guess, but he was busy. Last year, he led the league in tackles for 3 points, I think. But no forced fumbles, so.
Yeah,
an electric game. Back and forth, back and forth. And in the end, the Cowboys take the dub in overtime over the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are creating the NFC South champion and the runner-up in the NFC. So that's it. That's our week. I'll be back. We'll do stats. And yeah.